Hi and welcome to the tutorial for the Finish tab. Now if you find that the Finish tab is taking up too much space on your screen, you can always detach it from the icon bar and move it down to the bottom right hand corner so it takes up less space. And then when you press this button, you see it disappears. Now I'm going to leave it here, somewhere up here, so you can see it a bit better through this tutorial. Now to the left you have something called filters and actions, and that's exactly what it sounds like. They're simply filters where you can run them and you can decide what works best for you. Now, I'm just going to show you one of these because you can play with them in your images and find out which ones you prefer and which you don't. The one I'm going to show you is by far the most popular one out of all the filters, and it's called Magic Green Lands. And if you press that, it'll take a second or so to run because it's doing a lot of work, and then you'll see a pop-up box. This is for the Orton effect. So I'm going to leave it at around 41 and press OK. And now the action is finished running. So if we have a look at the Magic Green Lands group, you'll see we've created lots of different layers and we can take full control over these layers. And they all are labeled correctly so you can figure out what does what. Now I feel like this color is a little bit strong here in the foreground and in the sky. So I'm going to reduce this thing called Boost Greens. And you see we've brought back some natural color in now. I can also bring down the Orton effect if I find that it's a little bit strong, but I actually quite like it here. I can remove Protect Shadows if I want it to be a little bit darker, or I can remove this vignette if I want to add my own vignette. But let me show you what it looked like before and after. So here's before we added Magic Green Lands, and here's after, and you'll see it's a huge difference there. And it can turn any scene like this into a really vibrant, beautiful scene. And like I say, you have full control over how it's represented by playing with any of the layers that are in the Magic Landscape group. Now for your actions, when you downloaded Raya Pro, you should have seen a folder called Your Actions. And in that folder is a video for how to set up your actions and how to use those actions too. So we're not going to cover it in this tutorial. But please go back to the download and you'll see that folder as soon as you enter the Raya Pro download. Now reduce noise, well that just allows us to reduce noise. So if we click on it, it will reduce the noise in our photo using Photoshop's native noise reduction software. So when you see this pop up, you can play with the sliders and just press OK. And that creates a smart object which should have reduced any noise in your image. Now clean CA, this is for us to clean chromatic aberration. So if I just zoom in to this mosque here, let's go to this area here, and I press the Finish tab and open it up and put it here, you can see we have some strong chromatic aberration down here and along there. Now this doesn't work with every image, but it does work quite well with most scenes. All we need to do is press Clean CA, and now we have this pop-up and we bring the radius all the way down to zero. Now watch what happens as we bring it up. Let's say I bring it up to 5. You'll see the chromatic aberration is softened and spread. But if we do that a little bit higher, let's say to 20 or lower, let's say 13, it's spreading a little bit more and becoming more diffused. So now we're at around, let's say 21, you can't see much chromatic aberration. If we move a little bit higher, the chromatic aberration has completely disappeared. So just move this along until it looks right by you. And when you're done, you can press OK. Now we've created a chromatic aberration layer and this has a black mask on it. So select your brush, make sure your foreground's set to white and create a small brush. And all we want to do here is paint over the mask, those areas that have chromatic aberration. So we're just painting over those areas. And I'm going to do the green chromatic aberration too. Now you can see that this is a big improvement to the previous chromatic aberration that we had, even if it's not quite perfect. But nevertheless, it's a lot better than having the big red or blue cyan lines along our buildings. Now Sharpen Full-Size is exactly what it sounds like. We simply press Sharpen Full-Size and this will bring up our high-pass filter. And we simply decide the strength of our sharpening effect. When we're happy, we just press OK. Well, that's a little bit strong, but you can see exactly what it does there. If I delete that layer, we can go to something called Sharpen No Edge. And that essentially will allow us to sharpen our image without the white edging that we often see. And if you're interested in that, you'll see a link to a video pop up in the right-hand side of this screen, which will show you exactly how to use this function and the theory behind it too, so you can get a good idea of its uses. Now we can see frequency separation 16 and frequency separation 8. This is a function where we can separate the tones or the smaller aspects of our image from the larger aspects of our image and make really fine changes. Now again, I'm not going to show you how to do that because I've already created a more in-depth tutorial which you'll find really useful. And again, that's popping up on the screen in the top right-hand corner. So if you watch that, you'll see what frequency separation is, how to do it yourself, and also the different ways we can use it. And if you're a portrait photographer, you'll find this especially useful. Now these final options are quite obvious. So we can resize and sharpen our image by width or height. So I'm going to choose width here, and we have this pop-up box. So I'm going to say 1,000 pixels. And then you'll get an option which says, do you want to convert the color profile to sRGB, which is recommended for the web? And then we can press yes and okay. And now we've sharpened our image and we have all these different layers. So the first layer is extra sharp. And if we get rid of that, we have sharpened more, sharpened and not sharpened at all. So we can decide how sharp we want our image to be with those options. And as I say, we can do that via height or width. Here we can change the color profile of our image from sRGB to Adobe RGB or Profoto. And finally, we can save our images as we please, as a PSD or JPEG or a PSB. So these options here are quite easy to understand, and it will help you in your final steps in your workflow.